हेलो एवरीवन, दिस साइड नीतू सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इंद्रप्रस्थ लॉ कॉलेज. सो इन दिस सब्जेक्ट इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी लॉ, इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इन्फ्रिंजमेंट एंड पासिंग ऑफ ऑफ ट्रेडमार्क. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. व्हाट इज एग्जैक्टली इन्फ्रिंजमेंट? इन्फ्रिंजमेंट मीन्स, ट्रेडमार्क इन्फ्रिंजमेंट मीन्स बेसिकली द अनअप्रूव्ड यूज ऑफ अ ट्रेडमार्क ऑन रिगार्डिंग प्रोडक्ट्स एंड बेनिफिट्स इन अ वे दैट इज गोइंग टू कॉज कन्फ्यूजन, डिफिकल्ट अबाउट द ट्रेडर और पोटेंशियली बेनिफिट्स. सो अ रजिस्टर्ड ट्रेडमार्क इज इन्फ्रिंज्ड बाय अ पर्सन हु नॉट बींग अ रजिस्टर्ड प्रोप्राइटर और अ पर्सन यूजिंग बाय वे ऑफ परमिटेड यूज इन द कोर्स ऑफ ट्रेड. सो अ मार्क विच इज आइडेंटिकल विद और डिसेप्टिवली सिमिलर to the trademark in relation to goods or services in respect of which the trademark is registered. So after infringement, what will happen? The owner of the trademark can go for civil legal proceedings against a party who infringes the registered trademark. Okay, so one more important thing, that in this globalization, the infringement, most of the infringement of trademark happened on the internet. Wo kaise hoga? So suppose that an individual who develops a website online that discusses their expertise with Microsoft software could use Microsoft trademark to consult exact merchandise without the worry of infringement. However, that company mainly would no longer be competent to use the mark in this kind of means, as to intent viewers of her internet web page to feel that that company is affiliated with Microsoft, or that Microsoft is some way sponsoring her net web page. So the honor could simplest be analyzed upon seeing how the marks are sincerely used on the web page. So in this way, there is an infringement of trademark on the internet. So internet pe infringement kaise ho raha hai trademark ka? ये मैंने आपको एक एग्जाम्पल से यहाँ पर बताया. ओके, सो दिस इज द इन्फ्रिंजमेंट. दिस द इन्फ्रिंजमेंट ऑफ ट्रेडमार्क का मतलब ये होता है, वो होता कैसे है, इंटरनेट पे कैसे हो रहा है, आई विल गिव यू एक्सप्लेनेशन अबाउट दिस. सो नेक्स्ट इज केस लॉज रिगार्डिंग इन्फ्रिंजमेंट. सो देर आर सो मेनी केस लॉज, बट आई हैव टेकन ओनली टू केस लॉज ओवर हेयर. दिस इज Hearst Company versus Dalal Avenue Verbal Exchange Limited and Amritdhara Pharmacy versus Satyadev Gupta. These both cases are related with infringement. That will also help you in so many competitive exams. These two cases are so important. Please go through with these cases. So, and one more important thing, that no action for an unregistered trademark. This is defined under Section 27 of the Act, that no infringement will lie with respect to an unregistered trademark, but recognizes the common law rights of the trademark owner to take action against any person for passing off goods as the goods of you can say another person, as services provided by another person, or the remedies thereof. Means if your trademark is unregistered, then there is no meaning of infringement. Okay, that means the section 27. Okay, moving forward, next concept is passing off. What is passing off? Passing off is common legislation of tort which can be used to put in force for unregistered trademark rights. Okay, the regulation of passing off prevents one man or woman from misrepresenting other items or services. So the inspiration for passing off has faced some changes in the duration of time. In the beginning, it was restrained to the representation of one person goods to another. Later, it was elevated to business and non-trading activities also. Therefore, it used to be additionally accelerated to professions and non-trading movements. Today, it is applied to many types of unfair trading and unfair competitors where the activity of one person caused damage to another person. So, the fundamental question on this topic turns upon whether the defendant conduct is such as deceive or mislead the general public to the confusion between the industry activities of the two. So in British Diabetic Organization versus Diabetic, both the parties have been charitable societies and their names have been deceptively identical. The phrase is association and society, both should be considering that they have been similar in derivation and meaning and were not completely varied in kind. So the everlasting injunction was granted. Okay. This is the passing off. What is the difference between this passing off and infringement? So the measures for passing off is different from the measure of an infringement. The claim for infringement is a lawful remedy, whereas the claim for passing off is a common law remedy. Therefore, in order to establish infringement with respect to a registered trademark, it is only required to prove that the infringing mark is same or deceptively similar to the certified mark, and no more proof is required. So in the case of a passing off claim, proving that the marks are same or deceptively similar only is not sufficient. So the use of the mark should be likely to mislead or cause confusion. So moreover, in a passing off claim, it is necessary to verify that the use of trademark by the defendant is expected to cause injury or damage to the plaintiff goodwill, whereas in infringement suit, the use of mark by the defendant must not cause any injury to the plaintiff. Okay. So, when a trademark is registered, registration is given only with respect to a particular category of goods. Protection is thereof provided only to these goods. In passing off action, the defendant goods must not be the same. It may be different. So, these are some basic difference between the passing off and infringement. I have given there some cases also. This is Kaviraj Pandit Durga Dutt Sharma versus Navratna Pharmaceutical Laboratories, and one more, American Home Production Corporation versus Lupin Laboratories Limited. Okay, so here are two cases that must clear the difference between the your infringement and passing off. And one more case, that is Satyam Infoway Limited versus Cifinet Solution Private Limited. In this case, it was held that the court that to proceed action for passing off, three elements are required to the established, which are kya kya hai wo? In a trial for passing off, as the expression passing off itself suggests, is to restrict the defendant from passing off its goods or services to the public, which of the plaintiff. Second element that must be established by the plaintiff is a misconception by the defendant to the public, and what has to be placed in the possibility of the confusion in the minds of the public that the goods or services offered by the defendant are the goods or the service of the plaintiff. And the third element of a passing off action is loss or the possibility of it. So passing off के लिए अगर आपसे conditions पूछी जाती हैं या elements, तो वो कौन से केस में आपको elaborate किया गया, that Satyam Infoway, और here are three points आप mention करोगे तो that will cover your answer. So okay, so trademark registration under the act only has the effect in India. To get trademark rights and protection in other countries, it is required to register the trademark in those countries. Please remember that. And the trademark protection is regional in nature. A single registration will have to be made in every country where protection is wanted. To get protection outside India, it is required to file application in the respect of the countries individually. So, there should be the registration in a country before you begin the use of the trademark in that country. So, in some countries such as China, Japan, and continental Europe and Indonesia, the first person who applies for registration will get the right of trademark rather than the person who first uses the trademark. Please remember this. The different party could legitimately take trademark by applying for registration even if there is the first person using the trademark. Okay. So these are some basics, not relevant with this topic exactly. But yeah, these are some basics which I left over in our last lecture. So I covered here. So in this lecture, the infringement of trademarks, we just discussed what is exactly infringement on the internet, and we discussed some case laws related with the infringement. Then we discussed passing off, then we discussed some cases which differentiate between passing off and infringement. Then we discuss a case that is that lays down 3 points, that is Satyam Infove. Okay, so this is a complete topic about this infringement and passing off. So thanks a lot for this lecture, and in our next lecture we'll continue with the new topic. Thank you so much.